The sensor tile box is a small battery-powered box crammed with sensors and with Bluetooth. You connect to it with a smartphone. The app on the phone lets you control the box and display the data captured by the box. The sensor tile box can also work standalone without a smartphone. The sensor tile box bundle contains the filling material, the sensor tile box in its own blister, and the book How to Get Started with the Sensor Tile Box. Opening the sensor tile box blister, we find a small blue box without buttons, but with a micro USB connector. There is also a second bottom shell for the box with mounting flanges. Then there is a JTAG adapter board with a short 10-way flat cable. The cardboard cover has some instructions on how to get started with the device. The book included in the bundle has more details about the sensor tile box. In the first chapters, the basic and expert modes are explained, but beginning at chapter 5, things become more and more complex, and subjects like connecting the sensor tile box to the cloud or to an MQTT broker are covered. Chapter 6 deals with Pro mode, which is for embedded software developers. This is not really a mode of the box, it is just you creating applications for the sensor tile box from scratch. Inside the sensor tile box is a circuit board based on an STM32L4R9 32-bit ARM Cortex-M4 microcontroller. This is a pretty powerful device with a DSP and a floating point unit. The tile is equipped with several sensors. There's a digital temperature sensor, a humidity sensor, an altimeter pressure sensor, a 6-axis IMU, 3-axis accelerometers, 3-axis magnetometer, a microphone and audio sensor. Besides the sensors, the board also has a JTAG programming and debugging interface, so you can create your own applications for it. Under the battery hides a micro SD card slot. Note that in my case, the battery was not connected to the board. Connecting it is a bit finicky. After installing the ST-BLE sensor app on a smartphone and activating Bluetooth, you must pair the device with the phone with passcode 123456. Launch the app and tap Connect to a device. You can now have a play with the pre-installed demos. We are now in basic mode and we can change the program running on the device. Choose an application, select your device and upload the program.
Well, not convinced.
When you tap Expert View, you can build a custom application by combining predefined blocks. First, you select one or more inputs. Then you can optionally add a filter to it. Finally, you can choose how to output the data. I built a basic data logger application to record accelerations. The data is written to the micro SD card. When you connect the sensor tile box with a USB cable to a computer, the SD card shows up as an external disk and you can download the data. So let's give the sensor tile box a try in my super duper sports car.
Phew, that was exciting. Now let's see what we recorded.
Here is the data that the sensor tile box recorded. Sometimes my sensor tile box gets stuck for some reason, and fiddling with it I discover that pressing the user button can help in this case. In an online forum I discover that the user button is also the reset button. Unfortunately, when the box is closed you do not have access to this button, and so I drilled a hole in the box. While at it, I also drilled holes for the two other push buttons. With some adhesive tape you can make the box a bit more waterproof. The sensor tile box is an interesting device for measuring all sorts of environmental and movement data, and it allows you to quickly build data acquisition applications. Because it communicates over Bluetooth, it can connect through a smartphone or a computer all the way up to the cloud. Embedded software developers can completely customize the box. Thanks to its built-in battery and small size, it is also great for mobile and even wearable applications. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click or tap the bell button. Thank you for watching.